So yes, we've lost manufacturing jobs, but we need to make new connections and make sure that we're starting new ways of building up our economies and supporting each other. So these mittens will be made locally. Hopefully they'll be in time for Christmas. All the proceeds are going to programs that assist victims of domestic violence, because it's also Domestic Violence Awareness Month. But I'm trying to tell a story. We have resources here and connections that have been lost that we need to remake and support each other. So when you're going out over the holidays, buy something local. And when you go visit these businesses, understand their challenges, what they're working on, and support them. So I'm really happy to be here and to support all of you. And this is an awesome week. And thank you, Chad, for giving us the opportunity to celebrate it.
And now we have a reception in room 110, which is just down the hall. And hopefully everyone will join us there. Again, let's have a round of applause for Chad for really making this all possible. Thank you. And Paul just reminded me, too, that the movie was shown in D.C., and if you haven't seen it, it's really a great thing. And what time is that next Thursday?
Thursday,
6:30. 6:30, so people mark that on your calendar. And okay.
It was a joy to welcome Chad and others who produced the film into D.C. It was introduced that evening by Minority Whip Steny Hoyer of Maryland, who is one of the chief architects of the Make It in America agenda. And it was just great to be able to cite again this district with all of its manufacturing history as the agent that really produced that film. So I'm sure that so many took great pride. Marion and Peggy, obviously, sitting in that front row there, smiling and nodding approvingly. It's great to know that we're producing great things here, even films. So, good going.